Hi everyone, my name is Asfar.
Hi, it's Kim Boon here.
And right now you're watching Press Start. Press Start is basically our new show on Game Hubs where we take a look at new games that we are excited about. And for this first episode, we've got a big game for you guys. I'm pretty sure you guys have known this game for quite some time now. It's gotten good reviews. It's called Horizon Zero Dawn.
Yep.
Horizon Zero Dawn is an open-world action RPG created by the makers of Killzone.
Yep, Guerrilla Games.
Yep, this Amsterdam-based studio, they've only done FPSs before this.
Yep.
And this is the first foray into like a new genre.
Yeah.
But judging from the reviews and impressions, I think they've done a pretty bang-up job.
Yeah.
Why don't you talk about the story, the premise of the game?
So for Horizon Zero Dawn, you're controlling Aloy, who's a female protagonist. She grew up in this post-apocalyptic world, or shall I say post-apocalyptic world. Yeah, so how the world sets up here is machines roam this world, you know, in the form of like dinosaur-looking bodies, alright, where humans are living as following the tribe system.
Yep.
Yeah. So Aloy is just a character, is trying to find a place in this new world.
Yep. So is what's interesting about the storyline, it's not gonna be a spoiler anyway, but you basically start out the game as young Aloy.
Yeah.
And you basically see her grow from being a small kid, like six years old.
Yep.
And finally becoming like this, I don't know, I think she's like a teenager now.
Yeah, you can say so.
Yeah, and it's very interesting. It makes you, I think without the first part of the game, you'd feel very detached.
It makes you somehow in some way grow with the character,
yep.
You know? If you feel like, you know, there's a
sense, there's a connection, right?
Yeah, there's a sense of belonging there. Yeah, connecting you with the character and the story, you know, what's at stake at this world.
So right now we are going to a quest. This is like probably about 6 hours, 7 hours into the game. If you guys are sensitive to spoilers, please look away. So yeah, Kinwood, you've played this game earlier than me, since you got the review code. What did you think of the game so far?
Well, I played earlier, but I haven't reached this part yet because I just played the start briefly until point of the spear, something like that, where you fight the sawtooth. But yeah, so far so good. I enjoy the game a lot. It's like, don't even know what to expect of it, because when they first revealed it like last year, so everything looks good, you know, but then again you can only judge the game when the game is out. So
yeah.
After going through, like, even though just a brief intro of the game, I feel it's really good. I enjoyed how the game looks like really beautiful, even though I'm just playing it on a regular PS4. And combat is fun. There's always something different, like, because you face all these different kind of enemies. So despite you being stuck with your bow and arrow for most of the time, but combat definitely won't feel repetitive.
Yeah, that's what I was really pleasantly surprised about, is because I guess for most open world action RPG games, they can get a bit repetitive.
Yep.
Like one of the biggest games of 2 years ago, I think, was Witcher 3.
Alright.
And I love that game to death, but the combat got to a point where it was like kind of brain dead, was kind of boring. But this one so far, even like, you know, every enemy has their own special special personalities and weaknesses, and they have their own kind of way of going about the world. Like these striders, like, they're kind of like horses, so they don't actually attack you when you're nearby, but if you're nearby they will just like run away, but they won't attack you. But other enemies like the Watchers, they would attack you if you come close by. So it gives a lot of variety with all the different enemies.
Yep. And moving back to your example as a Witcher 3, right? As an example just now. Another game that can be compared with this is Skyrim, I feel.
Yeah.
The sort of open world, you know, where you can just like explore every nook and cranny of the game. But still, this game is more story centric, I feel, like compared to Skyrim,
yeah,
where
sure.
you can really get lost at the start, right from the start, especially when you're new to the series. But yeah, this game, it gives you story to follow, but at the same time, it gives you like plenty of freedom to, like, you know, just explore the world, do all the side quests. And
I think the thing with Skyrim is that the story didn't really grip me enough for
yep.
me to actually like invest in the main quest.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Like, I was just doing some stupid shit, just walking around and like picking up herbs and stuff like that.
Yep.
And I wasn't really, oh, should we fight this guy?
Yeah, you should.
Let's go fight this guy. So yeah, let's do some stalking. This is the sawtooth, I think.
Yeah, so this is the sawtooth, and you know, like we discussed earlier, so every enemy has its own weakness. So sawtooth, the weakness I believe is at the body, and it's weak to fire arrows. So
oh shit, I didn't know that. I can't climb here, can I? But yeah, the thing with this sawtooth is that it was before this, it was actually a boss fight, and now it seems like he's just like a normal monster. So let's try to get this guy.
There's gotta be.
So what you just did there is like, you know, yeah, you lure him, try to lure him past the trap that you set. So this is just one of the many ways where you can try to tackle a monster, because like, you can either go really quiet about it, or you can like, you know, set a trap. So it really depends on your playstyle, you know. You can just keep on blasting arrows to him, or you can see like Aspa over here is like going melee a bit.
Okay, Kimon, you have to keep on talking, because like when I'm fighting, I don't think I can concentrate on talking.
But yeah, this is just standard combat, I guess, as of now.
Oh shit.
Yeah, try to keep this hit spot.
What is this? Also, you have this focus thing where you can actually, you can actually find out where his weak spot is.
Yep. So you can see the body's weakness.
Whoa!
And,
dude! Oh. Chill. Oh my gosh. Oh shit.
And yeah.
We are dead. Oh, and also, I also have to say that I'm playing on hard right now because I'm a sucker for punishment.
Okay.
So yeah, I think if you guys played normal, it'll probably be a bit more.
Can still be punishing.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I play a normal, so
Kimbun is he's the worst. He's playing on normal right now.
I mean, it still can be punishing if you don't, like, you know, work out a strategy properly.
Really?
Yep.
Alright. Yeah, I learned my lesson there. So yeah, as you can see, I mean, even mobs on the field are still quite challenging.
Yep.
Yeah. And also another thing I wanted to talk about is just how amazing it is for this game to be made by Guerrilla Games.
Yep.
Like, the only games they've ever made was first-person shooters.
Yep, yeah. Famously known for developing the Killzone series, which is also a Sony exclusive, I believe.
Yeah. And also, like, it's a first-person shooter, and it's not even that great of a first-person shooter game.
I think the first few entries, it's developed for me because I feel... First few entries, is it Killzone 1 or 2, I believe, is for the PS2. That's not too bad. Yeah, but then moving on to later titles, I never really played any of them, but yeah. There's not much, what do you call that, rave about them, I guess.
Yeah. I mean, it was just... I think the Killzone games were basically just... They just showcased the graphics. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I can say so.
It was the launch game for PS4, Killzone Shadowfall, I think.
Yep.
And it was a beautiful game. I played it for a bit, but it was really shallow, very boring. But this one seems to be like more inspired and just more exciting to play, I think.
Yeah, and you know, since open world action games, like this sort of like open world action games, like the formula has been tried and tested by, you know, so many other games, but it's nice to see that, you know, Guerrilla managed to create an own identity for this game, you know, like with a female protagonist.
Yeah.
Combat system, your weapons, you know, bow and arrow, you know, you don't get much games nowadays that gives you a bow and arrow, and like it feels fun to, you know, control Aloy.
definitely more engaging than something like Witcher 3. I think Witcher 3 was just like, I think the reason I compare it off with Witcher 3 is because obviously it's an open world game, but I think The Witcher 3 feels like kind of a cliche take on open world. It's just, you know, the same setting that we've seen thousands of times before.
All right.
And this one is just a bit more interesting and more original. So the setting is basically post-apocalypse. So it's post-apocalypse, but thousands of years after the post-apocalypse. So the world has kind of regressed into this kind of caveman kind of.
Come here, girl. Let's have a
look
at you.
So what do we do here? What do we do here? Okay, let's talk to this guy.
Should have got out of
the girl with the mark of a seeker. The sentinel saw you coming.
You're Maria. Varl told me you'd know the way to Meridian.
The Karja capital. West will take you to it, but their soldiers will stop you long before you get there.
They can try.
No, what I mean is there's a Karja fort that guards the pass between east and west. Word is the Karja have sealed the gate out of fear of the corrupted machines infesting our sacred land.
So if I clear out the corrupted machines, they'll open the border?
I suppose. But I can't spare any braves to help you.
Who said I needed help?
You'll clear the valley all by yourself.
I'm good with a bow.
For your sake? Better than good, I hope.
So they also have this conversation system.
Yeah.
Very reminiscent of Mass Effect. I think Mass Effect
via
is
the BioWare RPG conversational stuff.
I think BioWare definitely popularized this. It's not super
so
in depth. I think it's
And beyond that, Meridian.
It's a bit like RPG light.
Yes, but it doesn't really put you like
the
good or evil comparison, right?
Yeah, so you don't have like a morality system going on. It's just purely like you play Aloy as how you want to play her. And the conversation system doesn't really factor into how she is as a character. You're not gonna be like an evil Aloy. You're not gonna be an evil Aloy.
But maybe personality wise it'll be something different, I guess.
Yeah, sure. But I don't think it will change the storyline. That's what I mean,
A kind of buffer between the Sunlim and our sacred land.
Okay, bye bye.
I should be going.
All right.
Why are we even wondering?
Right, so we are doing part of the main quest here. Is that right?
Yep. This is one of the main quests. I probably won't go to the story too much because just want to avoid spoilers for you guys. I think if you guys like what you see so far, I think it's better to just stop watching and play the game for yourself. I think this game deserves to be played with the least amount of spoilers as possible. Like even knowing the monsters that you'll fight is considered a spoiler for me.
Oh, okay.
Because it's part of excitement, you know, like
true.
You just, you know, you see this massive beast and you don't know what they're gonna do. You don't know their strengths and you don't know their weaknesses, and it was just felt really fresh playing it.
You can see the corruption coming off them like smoke.
Okay.
Time to clear them out.
So good shot. One more.
Ooh, hey, so slow. Hey! Yeah,
there you go.
So you have this ability to slow down time, which is very, very helpful because the game's auto aim system is it's not very generous. You have to really line up your shots properly.
Yeah, and it's very, really hard to do that in real time charging against you. So
definitely. But it's very satisfying to get a headshot. It's very satisfying to get a critical.
Yeah, talking about that, you can definitely feel like you're the controller, like when you pull your bow all the way back, you know, can feel like the tensile strength there, and especially when you hit that perfect shot, then there's a very high sense of satisfaction there.
Yeah, I think that's what they really achieve really well. Just the combat just feels really, really good.
Yep.
Like, it's enjoyable. Like,
rewarding.
Rewarding, yeah. Dude, it's relentless. Oh. Oh, come on.
Just one.
Oh,
more.
You can actually. One cool thing, I think they borrow this from Last of Us. You can actually craft on the go. So like right now, I just press L1 and it comes up this wheel where you can use it to change weapons as well.
Yep.
You know, I can use to my sharpshooter bow, and I can use to my rope caster. But at the same time, if I run out of ammo, just like just now, I can just press X and it will just craft the arrows for me right then and there. So that's pretty handy.
Yep.
Like these dudes, you gotta die.
This is a spear.
I didn't realize that. I didn't realize it was a one hit kill.
Yeah. That's if cool. You hit them with a strong spear attack, then you down them. And then it'll be easy for you to take down. Maybe to waste arrows.
Oh, I mean, oh shit. Ciao.
Yep. So always be on the lookout at your surroundings, because like when you're busy engaging with one enemy in front of you, there might be like a few like stalking nearby.
Oh,
and
these are new animals. Look at this. I've never seen this one before. So that's what I mean. Like, this game does have a lot of sense of wonder. I mean, if you're just exploring and suddenly you find a new monster or you find a new area, it really makes you feel excited to go and explore that.
Yeah, until you find yourself like dying like just now.
Yeah. Before recording, we went to this. Oh shit. We went to this new area, and then they had a new monster there, and yeah, we basically got killed pretty quickly. These guys are new, I think? Looks different than the other one. Now, all these have been pieced, they look pretty safe. Bye.
Okay. Okay, they're heading back.
Okay, wait, where do we go?
Right, so Asfa, like, can you like tell us like what aspects of the game that you like and you don't like?
Oh, okay. I think definitely what I really like is the combat. I love the setting.
Yeah.
I think it's really original. I just don't. I never really seen something like this before. The graphics, obviously, as you can see, is really gorgeous.
Yep.
And also we have to say that we're playing on a normal PS4 right now, not a pro, so still it looks really good. What else do I really like? I just really like everything about the gameplay, to be honest with you. I don't have a lot of complaints, I don't think so.
Right.
What complaints do I have? I gotta play a bit more of the game.
Corrupted Watchers.
To find out what I don't like about it. Oh yeah, one thing I don't like about it is sometimes the dialogue and the facial animation is not super great.
Okay. You mean like it doesn't sync up?
Yeah, it looks really awkward.
Alright. Yeah, I'm not talking about the lip sync, right? You're talking about like the characters doesn't really express the
I think
emotions.
Both the lip sync and the facial animation is not the best.
Okay.
It looks even more jarring because the game's graphics is really good.
Right? So it's quite noticeable, you say?
Yeah, it's an uncanny valley thing.
Surprise!
Oh. Jeez, crap. So I'm out of ammo, so I can just craft on the go.
Use a spear.
No! I don't want to use a spear. It's against my philosophy.
Okay, what's your philosophy?
Wait, what the hell?
Yeah.
What the hell?
That's what happened.
I got owned by some freaking.
Yeah, sometimes you just need to go simple, you know, use the spear, yeah. Especially when your spear can easily knock them down with a one strong hit.
Yeah, that's
here
why.
They come. Corrupted Watchers.
I'm gonna follow Kim Boon's.
Are these enemies part of the quest?
These ones, yeah. I gotta defeat the corrupted.
Oh, okay.
These are the corrupted ones. Okay, spear.
Yep. Maybe you can try and knock like one or two down using the spear first. Yep, you're almost dying again. Yes.
Oh, I'm slowed down. What the hell?
Oh, the crafter.
Okay, let's just think about this properly.
Games in a more chill pace. I mean, not to say normal, it's very chilling, but still, it's this looks too hardcore for me.
It's gonna feel so good. I'm gonna kill these people. Okay. Oh, what the hell?
Yeah, I don't think you can go too near to them.
Oh, I see.
Corruption, I think.
I didn't know that. Okay, this guy is definitely gonna die really soon.
I think we just found like a glitch or something.
He said no, he's like mentally ill person. Or robot, sorry.
I've done what I can to cleanse this valley of corruption.
Alright, so I guess this rounds up our discussion for today.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah, so I hope you guys enjoy what we have discussed or what you guys have watched, you know, despite Aswa trying his best to own the enemies. But yeah, so we'll come out with more videos next time, especially when there's like interesting game that comes out, you know.
This is something new that we want to try out. We want to just do some more engaging content instead of just, you know, informational videos. We also want to do these kind of first impressions, quick play kind of look into the game. We hope you really enjoy it.
So if you do, just leave a like, subscribe, or you can even, you know, give us comments.
Not leave a like. You gotta smash the like button.
Smash
the subscribe button.
Yeah, and leave a comment, you know, if you think there's anything that we should improve, or maybe you can even like give us some ideas on, you know, what kind of content that you want to see or games that we like to cover.
Yep. So it's been Aswar here and
it's Kim Boon.
See you guys later.
Sign off.